Hey, Gleb here. Today we're having a look at a pretty cool lighting quick tip, but from a standpoint of a formal composition and how it can help you to achieve a nice balance of tonal values in your image.
Now, before we begin, this lighting exercise blend file is available over on our Patreon. Not that it is required in any way. So let's assume we've got a typical outdoor scene bathed in a bit of that default sunshine, maybe a little bit more powerful than that. Probably the first and most crucial decision to make is the angle of this light source, right? Double R to trackball the light rotation, and instead of leaving it flat like that, which can feel a little sterile, you might actually want to angle it like that, making it 1,000 times more interesting. Seriously, this is one of the easiest things we can do, and arguably the most effective as well. Look at the definition it brings out in the shapes, the arrangement of scattered masses, these primary forms. It's just a more appealing composition visually, and gives the eye some interesting patterns to explore. As a next step, we might want to adjust the environment level to play with the overall contrast. But now for the real magic. Let's go Shift A, Mesh, and add in a plane. Let's make it much bigger so it blankets our entire field. As for its material, let's ditch the default and swap it out for the transparent BSDF. Surface. What I want to do next is break it up using the noise texture. So let's plug that into the color input. Control T to bring up these nodes, so we can really dial things in. And let's make it monochromatic via color ramping it. And then we can further refine its breakup by playing with these flags. So what we've essentially created here is a cloud shadow, a fantastic way to break up the otherwise very uniform light from our sun lamp. To make this shadow caster invisible in the viewport, we can uncheck the camera visibility option. So it's just the shadow. Again, the X, Y, and Z location can be adjusted to move the pattern around, and of course the noise settings as well. I'll make sure it covers the entire scene, like this. And there you have it, our very own cloud shadow. It's such a simple yet incredibly effective technique. Yet the artistic implications are just nuts. Think about it. It's another fantastic way to redistribute the light and dark areas within your frame, your canvas. It's so good. And of course, feel free to experiment with it a bit by softening things up a bit, by adding a secondary, larger area light, perhaps. This could help smooth everything out, releasing some of that formal tension, if you will. What I mean composition-wise is that if our only lighting tool is a harsh source, we are essentially left with a hard-edged brush to paint the tonal values onto our canvas. You can think of it in these painterly terms. So while the pattern of these tonal values or these masses might create a pleasing or interesting design with plenty to explore, the lack of smooth gradations between these tonal islands can look quite stark. Or as I said, it can make it look pretty tense, or intense, if you will. And that's exactly why we might want to introduce softer light, to create gentler transitions between those tones, and make the whole image visually less intense. Alright, the cloud shadow noise pattern can actually be in four dimensions, so we can animate its W, or evolution over time. Nice, right? I absolutely love this. It's yet another way of controlling the distribution of tones within your frame. I think we've even got a subtle S-shaped curve happening here now, which is a classic element of really effective compositions. It naturally guides the viewer's eye towards the depth of the scene in this organic, soothing way. It's usually a sign of a really, really strong visual. Actually, a neat way to animate that evolution is by typing in hashtag frame multiplied by some really low value, like 0.01, to make it slowly evolve over time once we hit play. That's pretty cool. To recap, reverse the light angle, then break it up with a dynamic shadow pattern, maybe soften it up a bit with a fill light, then we can go a step further and add some atmospheric haze, or maybe play around with the colors. And that's the whole technique. I'm really excited to see you try it out and make it your own. An alteration of this lighting technique is to use a volumetric object instead of a plane. Using volumes for casting shadows is not that different from using 2D planes, yet it has some inherent softness about it. If it's not, like, super dense, the volumetric media can actually let some light to filter through, due to scattering, among other things, giving you a free fill light at the same time, or it can even bounce some light back onto the scene, depending on the volume anisotropy. And of course, the elephant in the room, the volumes not only cast shadows but can also be physically present in the scene, if needed. So it's both shadows and their motivation. But essentially, still, it's fairly similar to using the flat planes. The tutorial should have ended here. Anyway, actually, it will work beautifully even with a more fronty lighting scheme. By the way, these desert landforms come from the amazing Foundations of the Earth pack by James Candy. The link is down in the description below, definitely worth checking out. Now, what we have here is literally a cloud, an object with a volume shader applied, and as you can see, we can move it around, it'll cast these fantastic cloud shadows. It's really quite simple, it's a principled volume shader, and its density is controlled by a texture, a noise texture to be precise. And just like before, the color ramp is our go-to for contrast adjustment. The rest, of course, is up to your artistic eye. You can slide the pattern around to achieve the perfect composition. So there you have it, yet another way to instrumentalize this crazy simple lighting technique. The secret ingredient behind some truly impactful visual creations. Alright folks, now let's try something different aside from just liking this video, although it is much appreciated. In one short sentence, tell me in the comments what is your favorite lighting slash composition hack that you have discovered on your artistic journey. You know, something that is super easy to implement and yet super effective. Speak it out in the comments.